Edit time checking notifies you of issues as you're editing, allowing you to address them as you go. Starting with the 22A release, you can define your own custom edit time checks. The steps and code presented here are available in this documentation topic. We're going to create three checks. The first check verifies that import and output blocks have certain colors based on their output data types. The second check verifies whether a trigger block is higher than other blocks in a subsystem. And then the third check verifies whether signals that connect to output blocks have labels. First, create an SL customization function and use the add model advisor check function to register the checks. In this example, define check is a check definition function. Next, in define check, create three model advisor check objects. Specify the check IDs as input arguments, the check title, and the callback handle property, which is the name of the class that defines the edit time check. For this example, my edit time check is the package name. Next, publish the checks to a new folder in the model advisor. Create the first check, port color, by creating a class that derives from the model advisor edit time check abstract base class. Save this file into a folder, name the same name as the package name. The port color method checks the check ID and traversal type properties. This traversal type checks newly added and edited blocks, but it does not have to check for other affected blocks in the same subsystem or model. The block discovered method checks the color of import and output blocks. Then it highlights the violating block by creating a result detail violation object for the block. The fix method provides a way to update the block with the correct colors. For the check for trigger block position, the traversal type is set to active graph because it must check other blocks in the same subsystem as a trigger block. The block discovered method checks the position of trigger blocks within subsystems. And the finish traversal method checks whether the position of these trigger blocks are higher than other blocks in a subsystem. Then a result detail violation object is created for the block. The last check verifies for signal labels on signals to outports. This check also checks newly added and edited blocks. The block discovered method uses the parameters on the line handles of the blocks to find signals that connect to output blocks, and then checks whether they have names. Then, because the violation is on a signal, a violation object with the type property value set to signal is created. Now we refresh customizations and open up the Model Advisor Configuration Editor. A custom configuration is created with just the three edit time checks. Now let's open up the model. I'll turn on edit time checks and specify the configuration file. The two import blocks are highlighted because they're INT32 and they should be cyan. I'll click on the warning, and since we added a fix method, I can correct the issue right here. I can also add a justification, which I'll do for the signal label error. Errors are flagged as you go. So when I move the trigger block below the other blocks, my check flags it, and I can correct the issue immediately. In summary, this example shows you how to create three custom edit time checks to find issues earlier. You can try the example for yourself using the doc example and start building your own checks.